Hi all, good morning. It's Wasim Naffar from HS Company in Jordan.
We have a speaker.
Today we are going to talk about at present EWD empowers Jordan. In Hakim, we have a mission. I will talk it about later. I will talk about it later. This vision leads us to use EWD to achieve our goal. So, what we will talk about during this presentation, for sure we will talk about the vision and mission, the major drawbacks in EWD and how we deal with it, our web development architecture, what we have implemented by EWD and what we are planning to implement by EWD. The vision. Hakim, our vision is to make Hakim health record accessible worldwide by the authorized person. In other meaning, to allow remote access for a health record in Hakim database, for sure by some restrictions and limitations. What's the mission? Our mission is to use EWD or any other relevant technologies to create and implement a web applications and mobile applications for the current Hakim packages and applications, such as a dental package, patient registration, patient scheduling, and many others. So, the software department, after we have defined the vision and the mission, we try to find what's the best way or what's the best solution to use, and it's an easy, and we are trying to find an open source and free technology to achieve this our mission. So that's why we adopt EWD in this space. But during using the EWD, we had a major drawbacks, and I will mention them. The first one is to the EWD is accessing the GTM Global's directory, which is a security issue. And the second major drawback, that EWD cannot call Vista RPC directly, which is a reusability issue. And the third one is a user session management issue. And now, I think 1 week ago, we had another major drawback, which is character encoding. As you know, in Jordan, we use Arabic characters, which is a UTF-8 character encoding. That means we have another major drawback now. So, in Hakim Jordan, the development team has connected the EWD team to try solving these problems or this major bug. And after a while, the EWD team with David Wixell and Robert Weed, they are finding the solutions and the fixing for this major drawbacks. So I would like to thank David Wixell and Robert Weed for their great effort to help HS Jordan to fix this major drawbacks. And the EWD, after that, has created a new and free web source EWD. GS custom extensions that provide secure, very high performance access to all RPC within Vista, and they call it RPC Procal. So again, access GTM global directly is a really major drawback that may cause a data integrity issue. So, and as you know, there is a many RPCs in Vista that we can reuse for our applications and for any new applications. So that's why we are focusing on these points. What's the R development architecture? It's a three tiers. It contains a client and a web Apache server, and in the third layer tier, it's a Vista server. So in the clients, as you know, it consists of tablets, iPhones, mobiles, PCs, laptop, whatever. And in the middle tier, there is a web Apache. And the reason for that is for the load balancing and security reason. The protocol between the clients and Web Apache Server is at SSL TLS, and they configured a firewall for security reasons. So, and in the third tier, there's a Vista server and EWD embedded in the Vista server. Now, I wanted to talk about what we have implemented during the past period by using EWD. As I told you, EHS adopt EWD to implement and create the pillow applications, and those applications are in production now with alpha version. The first one is the Dr. Hakim mobile application, and I will talk about it in more details and show you some screenshots and what is the purpose for and the main purpose for this mobile application. The second one is the dental package web application, and as you know, in Vista we didn't find a configured or an implemented dental package, so we created from scratch the package in Vista, and then we implement the web application. The last one is the electronic medical record review tools web application. So, first one is the Dr. Hakim mobile application. This application is to enable the physicians to track down their patients' medical appointments remotely, wherever they are and wherever they want to. It also provides full details about patients' medical history, such as vital signs, allergies, health problems, lab tests, radiology reports, and medications, in order to improve the healthcare process. Now, I will talk about the main functionalities in this mobile application. The first one is the main clinic screen. As you see, it displays the main clinics in Hakim, and the doctor can choose any one of those clinics. And after that, when he selects one of these clinics, it will display, the system will display the subclinics related to the selected clinic. The third or the other functionality is the appointment screen. Once the doctor selects the subclinic, he can view the appointments that relate to this doctor and this clinics. And as you see in the first, in the left screen, there is an appointment for the selected subclinic, and the doctor can choose any one of this clinic, of these appointments, and see more details about these appointments, such as the patient information, if there's a doctor instructions, clinic instruction, and any more. And there is a patient information screen, which displays a patient's basic information in addition to his vital signs and medical record. So the doctor can see the patient information, and such as a mobile number, gender, whatever, and he can see more details such as the vitals, as I told you, and more information. And we have in this application another functionalities or another screen, such as lab test detail screen, which enables the doctor to view his patient's lab orders and test orders. And the doctor can select any one of these orders to view more details about a lab, such as a collected by, collection sample, specimen, urgency, and many others. And otherwise, there is a radiology screen also that enables the doctor to view his patient's radiology reports. And in the same way, it will display the radiology orders, and the doctor can choose any one of these to see and to view more details about the radiology order. So, Dr. Hakim mobile application will be available in Google Play Store for smartphones in both languages, Arabic and English, and the developers are now trying to implement iOS version for iPhone also. So that's about the mobile application.
How do you retrieve the data, or do you maintain it only on the application? On the mobile app, or is it stored in a Vista site?
No, on the Vista site, yeah. There's nothing to work on that.
And do you use remote procedures to retrieve that?
Exactly. As I told, there is a major drawback in the WD. They access directly the global. And now they fix it by create an extension EWD, the JS, that we can call an RPC. And now we're using, we reuse some RPCs for CBRS, for example.
What's different about accessing globals directly. You do it in months all the time. What makes a difference here?
But when we use a Vista APIs, it checks some conditions or there is some verification. For example, if you wanted to delete an entry and you want to delete it directly from the global, maybe, as you know, this will lead to a database integrity issue. But when we use, for example, a DI or whatever API for deletion, there is some checks. That's what
I don't see a difference still. There's just this is the way it has always been in months, is that, you know, essentially the developer is responsible for assuring database integrity. So the statement is just inaccurate. You should say that, you know, we want to assure the use of other APIs, and there's nothing directly intrinsic to accessing the database that would make a difference, really. It's not, I would say, it's a drawback. You just wanted a higher level API.
Yes, you're right, yeah. But as you know, it's the most important thing is to call RPCs. This is the most important thing. Thank you.
So you developed your own web demo application?
Yeah.
Cool.
Show you our web applications. The second one is the dental web application. For sure, this all in production, but an alpha version. I mean, there's just main functionalities, and there's some bugs. We are trying to fix them. So the second one is the dental package web application. Dental package offers a general dentistry for patients in all age groups. The dentists are able to provide comprehensive treatments for patients efficiently and effectively. Dental package is needed by a dentist to provide a complete documentation process, treatment plan, orders, medications, and retrieval of dental history. This package. Sorry?
Oh, will you make the dental package available in open source?
I think it will be.
Okay, that'd be lovely.
Yeah. This package will provide all the needed features that are specific for dentists and are not provided in CPRS. Now I will show you what this application contains. It contains actually five tabs. The first one is the primary dentition tab. The second, permanent tab, and there is a tab, treatment notes tab, dental history, today work tabs. And I will explain each one of them. The first one is the primary tab. This is the main screen for the dental package. We use it by CPRS. I mean, when the doctor log in or the physician log in by CPRS, he will choose the tools and the dental web application will pop up. Okay? So this is the main screen for the dental web application. And as I told you, it contains five tabs. In the left side, there's a patient information. The first primary tab contains the dentist work on the primary tooth. And by clicking on the tooth, it opens a window to fill the pool, the tooth work and procedure and diagnosis. A dentist can order x-ray exams for the patient and insert x-ray results and view x-ray history for the patient. And I was trying to make an online demo, because I know if we just explain, it will not be clear for you. But again, when he click on the tooth, it will show a pop-up and the doctor can enter data. And that, as I said, can order x-ray exams.
So can he draw his filling in
mind? Probably in the finer detail. When you select the two, it comes up with.
Yes, I think so. Yeah. they created that, yeah. And I'm trying now with the team to make an online demo or at least a demo for you, and we will share it and we will upload it for the WorldVistA community.
Marvelous.
For sure.
Marvelous.
So, you're storing an imaging, or when you do a diagram, where are you storing that?
Where we store it?
Yeah. In images?
Do you have a
file
man file?
I think, no, in a file man file, yeah. Not the same image.
Oh, you're not doing it. So
they're
not.
They're diagrammatic. rather than actual images.
No. Well, this is the primary. I will show you the permanent. Yeah, so the second one is the permanent edition, right?
So as a brand new package, you're not going to recycle any legacy code or legacy RPCs. It's a brand new greenfield application, right?
Yeah.
So how are you making calls into this database for that? You're not wrapping RPCs, or you're creating new RPCs, or how are you writing?
No, we are reuse on RPCs, and we create for sure RPCs.
Okay. Yes. It's still RPC based.
It's an RPC. Exactly. So, but just I wanted to write your note, and maybe I will come back with the answer for you.
Okay.
Because I don't have a full knowledge about this application.
If Gary comes, the person I'm hoping is going to come, we probably need to sit down for a moment, because I think we'll use imaging.
Yeah.
Maybe to the scan program to file some of these things where
right.
They can actually draw in the picture.
Right.
So as I understand, this picture is always the same, and it just changes based on a particular person, right? So primary identification is the kids, right?
Yeah. I will show you now in the second screen the permanent identity. That's your question, or what?
No, I'm just saying, do you actually have markings to mark the top of it, or a crown, or if you have bridges?
Yeah.
Does the picture change, or does the picture stay the same?
No, it's the same picture. Aesthetic, yeah.
You would assume, I recognize you don't have a demo here, but the color coding below the image of the teeth there would only mean something if the tooth is actually color, has some of that color on it.
Exactly.
So is the tooth A or whatever up there would have a little green on it showing that it's got a filling.
It's the best way to show you a full demo. I don't know if I can do that by the end of today, to connect remotely with someone in Jordan to show you. I just here to mention what we implemented by using AWD, but I hope if we can in the next conferences show you a full demo by mobile application also, to bring the tablets or mobile and show you full demo and for the dental packet.
I think you can tell by the number of questions coming up that people are very interested in that.
Very nice.
Because actually I don't have, I'm not with the guys during the implementation, just I took the screenshots and a brief description for each screenshot, and that's it. But
I'm just sending you the updates.
Any question? Any more question? Okay. The next tab is the permanent dentition, and it contains the dentist work on the permanent tools. Same as the primary dentition, when clicking on the tooth, it opens a window to fill the tooth work and procedural diagnosis. Dentist can order x-ray, also exams for the patient and insert x-ray results and view the x-ray history for the patient.
I think this is answers your question, Nancy.
Well, but that's some imaging. That's in the x-rays, right?
If he can order it. If he can order an X-ray through the dental package, then he has to go to the imaging system and store the images on VistA Imaging.
Yeah, I'm thinking he's using
all the dental history for the patient. I know there's maybe you will ask a question, but actually what I know is it contains the date and the beginning of the diagnosis, tooth, position, procedure, status. Yeah, I don't know if you have any question about this.
My only question was about the previous one. Do the notes get stored in TIU?
The previous one?
You can see them from CBRS.
Sorry?
Do these notes, the dental notes,
yeah,
do they get stored in the TIU Global,
yeah,
the same as the other progress notes?
Yeah.
And so that you're able to, given the proper permission,
yeah,
you're able to view those notes using CBRS?
Yeah.
He's asking if the notes are stored in templates. So,
in the TIU templates?
Yes.
Yeah.
So they are reflected on CIP errors?
Yeah, maybe. Yes, yes, right, you are right. They're reflected in.
Thank you.
The first, another tab is the dental history for the patient. I talked about it. And the last one is the today word, which contains the today dental work for this patient that was done by the end provider. And this step enables the dentist to cancel a work, and an electronic signature in this case is required. That's it about, this is the main tabs, the main functionalities that are, exist in the dental package. The last web application is the electronic medical record review tools web application, and this allows the user, this web application allows the user to check the inpatient record completeness and the input quality before the discharge action. And it displays different kinds of information such as order during admission, allergies, diet orders, notes, so such information to the users in order to score this record completeness. And the user can select anywhere, and the system will display all the current admitted patients on this one. This is the main screen for this web application. It shows medical record review, such as allergies, adverse drug reactions, immunization status. And there is a note, and and this is also in production with an alpha version, and they are working to add more functionalities for it now. There is another tab also, it's a notes tab.
I noticed you had immunization. Do you only have it for children, not for adults?
No, not.
Okay, it's a darn good start.
And it's also we'll try to make a full demo for the project. I know most of you, they are interested for this, and Khamis now is trying, you know Khamis, trying to make a full demo for the and we'll upload to community. For sure with the source code for web applications, JavaScript. As you know, AWD is a JavaScript, so upload also the JavaScript AWD side for mobile and for web application, in addition to the RPCs and WorldVistA WAMS code.
So which version of AWD are you using?
Version 2. Do you ask about version?
About AWD, I mean, do you use AWD Classic, AWDJS?
AWDJS, yeah. So that's about the three applications, and we are planning now to implement more web applications, such as a patient registration web application for the patient. In Jordan, we have a desktop application for patient registration, to register a patient and to update his information. It's a desktop implemented by C#. And now we are trying to implement a web application for patients. A CBRS web application, and for sure it will be only for basic functionalities and alpha version. As you know, a CBRS is a huge application. We cannot implement a web application for CBRS, but we are trying to implement a basic, and we are now in the initiation phase to collecting what is the basic functionalities that should be in the first version for CBRS.
So you
and we are also planning to implement a scheduling appointment at web application, and for sure, for only the basic functionalities, it's a huge project. Sam knows about scheduling, he knows how many functionalities are implemented there. So, that's it. And I write down all your notes because I'm sorry, I don't have full answer for all your questions, but I will try to come back with the answer. Thank you so much.
Good. Thank you.